local schools are putting their differences aside to kick out cancer. KMBC 9's David Hall joins us live with why this fight strikes so close to home for these students. David?
That's right, Kelly. We are here at Park Hill South, where two schools are coming together using this ball and the sport of soccer to try and fight cancer.
On this night, this heated rivalry softened up a bit with hopes of making cancer quit.
We have a big rivalry and everyone comes out, and especially for soccer and cancer.
You may know Nicholas Hiblett from watching his Park Hill High School soccer team try to beat other teams. What you may not know is that since earlier this year, he's been trying to beat testicular cancer. He found out through a physical.
When I'm out there, I'm just with all my friends and I'm as happy as I can be, and I just forget about cancer and everything, and it just takes everything off, and it's just awesome being out there.
With some help from some Sporting KC players, Hibbler, along with other players from Parkville South, played a varsity soccer game for the Kick Out Cancer Soccer Challenge. They're raising money with a raffle and silent auction. Joel Toigo is South's soccer coach. His wife is dealing with breast cancer.
Pleasing for me to see, first off, how many people you don't even know that care about you and your family. People are stepping over each other to help do things for us. But also, it's been neat to see our boys on a different level. That it's not just about soccer and things like that. They care.
Care is something that this young man has, and he wants to show it by giving you some advice.
Make sure you check yourself and have your physical done well, and just check yourself every once a week because it could save your life.
And all the money raised will go towards the Victory Project, which basically helps KC kids who are also dealing with and fighting cancer. And as for Nicholas, who you saw in our piece, in 2 weeks he will learn if he will have to deal with surgery, but we wish him well in his fight with cancer. And as far as this game is concerned, as we can see, it is still a tied game. So a lot of spirit and passion out here in this game, and we will tell you who won the game coming up a little bit later at 10 o'clock in our evening newscast. That's the very latest, reporting live from David Hall, KMBC 9 News.